With Bitcoin looking as bullish as ever, it's inevitable that we start discussing and maybe daydreaming about how high we think BTC could go. But in this video, I looked at the maths and data behind this Bitcoin bull cycle to see where this market may peak, and it's probably a lot higher than you may be thinking. But first, let's look at some other Bitcoin price valuation methods with the price forecast tool chart we have here on BitcoinMagazinePro.com. Now, this tool is entirely free, so I definitely recommend checking it out and keeping an eye on it as the cycle progresses. But what we'll do is look at a few of these different valuation methods, which have historically been incredibly accurate for BTC, to see if we should be paying attention to any of them going forward for potential top marking prices. One thing I will say before we get too much into the mass data, price predictions, all of that good stuff, is it's definitely better to react to the data rather than predict. It's all good fun looking at this, but realistically, if all the on-chain data, macroeconomic, derivative, technical, etc., is all pointing towards a market cycle peak, doesn't matter what price we are, at that point, consider taking some profit. But that's not very fun. So we'll continue on with this. And firstly, we'll look at the top cap. Now, for all of these metrics, you can actually scroll down beneath the chart and see the full calculation methodology behind all of them. But initially, we'll look at the top cap, like I said, and this isn't actually an on-chain derived metric. This is just purely based on the Bitcoin price action. What we do is take the average cap, which is the cumulative sum of market cap divided by the age of the market in days, and then just multiply that by 35. Now, what we can see is this has been historically fairly effective, but maybe recently has lost its effectiveness. We can see in the previous 2020 into 2021 cycle, this did not predict the Bitcoin cycle peak. As we were topping out, this was somewhere between $130,000 to $190,000, $200,000, depending on which of the double top peaks you're actually looking at. We can see prior to this, it was incredibly accurate, such as in 2017, when it pretty much marked the exact cycle peak to perfection, and in the previous cycles as well. But this isn't one I'm going to be watching too closely going forward. As we can see, it's currently forecasting a Bitcoin price of well over $500,000. So maybe if you like Plan B stock to flow model, you can also look at this one. But personally, I don't think that this is a realistic target for this cycle. What we then can then look at is something that's a little bit closer. Now, this is the delta top. Now, again, we can scroll down and see that the delta top is actually using some of the data we've actually calculated in the top cap. So we can see the average cap, which we calculated previously, is the one of the numbers that we're using in the delta cap. It's the realized cap subtracting the average cap. Now, the realized cap is similar to the realized price. It's the average accumulation price or cost basis of all Bitcoin on the network. And then we can just multiply that by the circulating supply to get the realized cap. Now, what we can see is once we do this, we actually get some fairly decent price prediction and price forecasting models. We can see it wasn't exactly perfect in the 2017 cycle as Bitcoin topped out. And I think December 17th it was. This was predicting a price of over $25,000. So again, not perfect, but in the previous cycles, it was very accurate. And the 2020, 2021, again, not quite perfect. We could see as Bitcoin was topping out in this first peak at around $60,000+, this was closer to $80,000, $90,000, even close to $100,000. So again, maybe a decent model to be looking at, but my personal favorite of all of these is the terminal price. The one that I think will definitely be the most accurate and has the highest potential of calling the Bitcoin cycle peak in this bull run. If we just scroll down here, once again, we can see how the terminal price is calculated. It's using the coin days destroyed. Well, it's derived from the coin days destroyed. So the coin days destroyed looks at the amount of Bitcoin that's been transferred and weighted it by the amount of time it's been held to almost give a velocity of Bitcoin. And then what we can do is take that and then multiply it, or divide it, sorry, by the supply of Bitcoin that had been in circulation at that moment in time, and then multiply it by 21. This was made by Checkmatey as well. James Check, if you're watching, really appreciate the content you made. Definitely one of the best on-chain minds in the space. But if we go back up here, we can see that this is the only one of these price forecasting tools that has correctly forecasted the Bitcoin price cycle peak in every single Bitcoin bull market. We can see even in 2021, as we had this muted kind of double top, this still forecasted the Bitcoin price pretty much to perfection. As Bitcoin was topping out around $64,000, this terminal price was at around $62,000-$63,000. So incredibly close to perfectly calling the cycle peak. I know we made an all-time high a few months later, but we'll just ignore that and focus on this initial peak. And then looking to previous cycles, we can see again in 2017, as Bitcoin topped out, this was actually slightly beneath the Bitcoin cycle peak. So there is the chance, of course, that we actually slightly surpass this. Now, this is currently at $221,000, but do keep in mind that these values are changing every single day. And by the time we actually potentially reach this price target, it may be even higher at $250,000 or even more. Now, what we're actually going to be doing to mathematically forecast the Bitcoin price cycle peak is looking at the Bitcoin MVRV ratio. So again, I mentioned the realized cap previously. It's the average accumulation price or cost basis of all Bitcoin on the network. And once we aggregate all of that and multiply it by the circulating supply of Bitcoin, we'll get this realized cap. Now, what we can do is if we just remove the Z score, a lot of people just focus on the MVRV Z score, but we actually have the MVRV just default ratio here as well. This is purely dividing this market cap, the price, underlying price of Bitcoin by this realized cap or realized price. Now we can see currently, as I film this, it is a value of about 2.34. What we can see is historically Bitcoin does tend to top out on the MVRV ratio at around a value of 4. Sometimes it'll obviously surpass this slightly, but it's only for a very brief moment in time. So we can see when the average investor is at about a 4x of unrealized gains on their position, potentially market psychology, potentially coincidence. This is usually when the market is topping out or at least very close to a cycle peak. Now we can see in the previous cycle, we didn't quite reach that. We reached a value of 3.96, but still it was a very decent effort and very close to 4. But we need to acknowledge that looking at every single one of these peaks, there is the trend of diminishing returns. So we need to acknowledge that we may not hit a cycle peak of 4 this cycle. So we may need to slightly lower our targets. What we can do is if we just look to potentially some other peaks in the Bitcoin price action throughout Bitcoin's history, we can see this initial run up to around $40,000. The MVRV ratio is about 3.79. A few months later, after we'd had the major peak on this, again, it was 3.79. Back here, it was 3.69 before we had a big drawdown in the 2017 cycle, but didn't mark the cycle peak. And then back here in the double peak cycle, 3.5, back here even earlier than that, 3.69, 3.67. So definitely around this kind of 3.5 to 3.8 region, there's definitely a lot of activity. Usually at this point, we usually have a little bit of a retracement, or potentially we've far exceeded this value of 4. This is where we actually retrace to before a little bit of a bounce. Again, could be a coincidence, but it's a number that we'll be focusing on today. We'll be using the more conservative level of 3.5. So if we just draw that on the chart here, this would assume that in this Bitcoin bull cycle, we'll see the MVRV ratio hitting around this level before a cycle peak. So again, as I said, diminishing returns, but still giving us plenty of upside potential for this cycle to continue. Now, what we also need to look at is the Bitcoin growth since cycle lows. Now we can see I've just removed the previous cycles. We're just focusing on the 2017 and the 2020 cycle. And what we can see is currently we're about 930 days into this cycle. Now, interestingly enough, the previous two cycles actually topped out at pretty much the exact same time in terms of days since the cycle low. So we could see the 2017 cycle was about 1,067 and the 2021-2022 cycle was about 1,060. So somewhere around that 1,060 days from the cycle lows is where Bitcoin typically tops out, well, at least looking at the previous two cycles. Now, of course, everyone's gonna say the four-year cycle's ending, we're seeing diminishing returns and lengthening cycles, etc. At the minute, this has to be our base case. This has happened on the previous two instances. Everyone always says, yeah, but this time it's different. That was the narrative in the previous two cycles as well, I can assure you. So until the data proves us otherwise, we have to rely on the data. We have to assume that the four-year cycle is currently our base case. And given the fact that the previous two cycles topped out at pretty much the exact same time, we maybe have to, again, maybe assume that we're going to top out at a very similar time in this cycle as well. So that's what we'll be using for our maths as well. So about 130 days from now, given we're 930 days into the cycle, is where we could see the Bitcoin price topping out. Now, if I open TradingView here, what we can see is this is the realized price and the underlying Bitcoin price. So obviously the Bitcoin price in green and this realized price is this orange line. Now, what we can see is it's impossible to really gauge exactly how high Bitcoin could go just looking at the realized price, considering as we're close to topping out, this realized price is usually going exponentially to the upside. Retail FOMO is happening, people are piling into the market, and this euphoria is what typically drives the big blow-off tops we see in the Bitcoin price action. We could see as Bitcoin entered December in 2017, just as we were surpassing $10,000, everyone was going crazy, finally we're into the $10,000 territory, and maybe we're about to top out now, the Bitcoin price at $10,000, the realized price somewhere around here, about $3,000. And 2 weeks later, the Bitcoin price had doubled and the realized price again had gone up massively from that moment in time. Just for reference, again, you can see on the TradingView chart there, but if we just go to this chart here, what we can actually see, just again, so we have a little bit of frame of reference of the current values we're working with, the realized price as I film this is $47,000. And again, we'll just go back to TradingView. One really interesting thing is if I put this on here, in the 130 days, prior to the Bitcoin cycle peak. So given where we potentially may be in this cycle, 130 days before the cycle peak, we could look at the Bitcoin realized price and we can look at the percentage gain it made in the 130 days that followed. And that was 260%. It may be a little bit hard to read on your screen now, it's pretty small on TradingView, but it increased 260%. This is the realized price before the Bitcoin market topped out, judging by the increase from 930 days into the cycle. Now what we can do is scroll across to the next cycle and add it on here. So 130 days before the Bitcoin cycle peaked. Now this isn't the ultimate peak we made in this cycle, but it is the peak we made in the MVRV ratio as Bitcoin first surpassed kind of this $55,000-$57,000 towards $60K. And we can see in the 130 days leading to this cycle peak or data peak, the realized price increased by 130%. So almost exactly 50% lower than we saw in the previous cycle. So again, assuming diminishing returns, assuming this trend is going to continue, what we can do is just assume that the realized price from our current value around $47,000 may increase by about half of 130%, so about 65%. So we just scroll over here. What I've done is added on this 65% increase 130 days into the future. Now this would forecast the realized price on the 18th of October as I film this to be around $78,000, slightly higher, slightly lower, depends. Of course, this isn't an exact science. Now what we can do, taking that $78,000 number, if we would see the realized price do something like this, where it increases and then starts to rapidly increase as the Bitcoin price is rising higher, what we can do is almost just work backwards. So if we go back to Bitcoin Magazine Pro here, and then back to this chat, what we can do is assume, like we said, an MVRV score of about 3.5. And when we're assuming a realized price of around $78,000, that gives us, if I just open my calculator here, because I did just do the maths a minute ago, that gives us, drumroll, a Bitcoin price target, mathematically predicted price target based on the historical trends and patterns we've seen in the Bitcoin data, of $270,000+, $273,000 to be exact. Now, do I think that this is a realistic target, a realistic possibility for this cycle? Honestly, I think this may be slightly high. I don't think Bitcoin maybe has the potential to reach that this cycle, although of course I love to be proven wrong. And looking at something like the 2017 cycle, we can see that Bitcoin can starting to getting overheated towards a cycle peak, and 2 weeks later the price could have doubled. So maybe, you know, in 120 days time, Bitcoin's price is $140,000, $135,000. We're all saying that the market peak is in. You blink and you miss it, we're at 270K. That could of course be the case. But like I said initially, it's way better to react to the data than try and predict. If by the time Bitcoin's price is topping out, we're seeing lots of long-term and experienced large holders begin taking profit on their positions, if we're looking at something like the MVRV Z score, or even its derivatives, the short-term holder, the two-year rolling, the long-term holder MVRV, if all of these are starting to flash, take profit. Don't be the one sitting waiting for a fixed price target. A lot of people have been burnt in previous cycles doing that. And unfortunately, the reality is a lot of people will be burnt in this cycle doing the same. Also, please don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and turn on notifications to ensure you're receiving all of our content as soon as it's released. And make sure to check out all the charts we've discussed today, as well as the many more that are all available on BitcoinMagazinePro.com, your number one source for Bitcoin analysis. And again, let me know in the comments below and on social media, do you think that this is a realistic price target? Or do you, like me, maybe think that this is slightly too high for this cycle? Am I just being pessimistic, or am I maybe being a bit of a realist? As I said, let me know. I look forward to reading and replying to them. So just to summarize, predicting the Bitcoin price into the future is almost always going to be wildly inaccurate. There are simply too many variables and future unknowns to forecast such a volatile asset such as Bitcoin. It is always better to react to the data as it comes in. Looking at things like the MVRV two-year rolling, the value days destroyed, things like that, which are actually based on on-chain movement, are going to be far more accurate and indicative of when the market cycle peak is occurring, rather than just fixed price targets that we have on our charts. However, looking at some metrics that have historically marked the Bitcoin peak with a high degree of accuracy, like we could see with the terminal price, there is evidence to suggest that this cycle could far surpass $200,000. As we said, all of these metrics are currently forecasting pretty high prices, but they're increasing every single day. And especially if we do see a blow off top, if we do see huge FOMO coming into the market, these are going to rapidly accelerate to the upside. And looking at historical trends and patterns, we can roughly forecast using the MVRV ratio, a potential price peak this cycle of $270,000. Like I said, I might be being a little bit pessimistic. I think that might be a little bit too high. I'd be pretty surprised if we surpassed 250K, but as I said, it's gonna be better for me and my bank account to be proven wrong in this instance. If you like this video, then please visit BitcoinMagazinePro.com, where our analytics help you to cut through the noise to make informed, data-driven decisions about Bitcoin. With over 150 live charts, personalized indicator alerts, in-depth crypto industry reports, API access, and more, offer a fraction of the standard industry price. And let me know what your thoughts are on potentially Bitcoin topping out at over $200,000, maybe $270,000. Do you think it's possible, or do you maybe think that we're not gonna reach that high? As I said, let me know in the comments below and on social media. I look forward to reading and replying to them. Thank you all very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.